Hello friends, I am Satyendra and welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to explain a very important question. This question is from the chapters of quantum mechanics, and this question was asked in CSIR NET June 2016. I am extremely sorry that the letters and words are a little blurred, but in the upcoming pages that won't be blurred. Okay, so I will, for your help, I will read this question. Okay, the eigenstates corresponding to the eigenvalue E1 and E2 of time independent Hamiltonian are this is the eigenstates. Okay, this is the first eigenstate and this is the second eigenstate respectively. If at t equals to 0, the system is in the state. So if at time t equals to 0, the system is in this following state, okay, which is the combination of this and this state. Okay, the value of this this inner product at time t will be, okay, so we have to calculate this inner product. Okay so let's see how we can solve it. Okay, so the wave function at time t equals to 0 is given. It is already given in the question that the wave function at time t equals to 0. Okay, the wave function at now you have to know one important concept. The wave function at time t, that is called the time development of the state, okay, is obtained by multiplying this factor or this factor, okay, to each term, okay, where this en energy en equals to omega n into h naught, okay. Okay, where n will be taken as per the state n, okay, so that you will understand very soon, don't worry about it. Okay, so here from this, this was the state at time t equals to 0, and in order to find the state at time t equals to t, I have to multiply this factor at each term of this. Okay, so I have multiplied and you can now see that. Okay, so I have multiplied that factor here, okay, and also I have multiplied that factor here. Okay, so this gives me on multiplication the state at time t. Now you can see that here the n equals to 1, because here we are dealing with the here the term has the 1 inside the caret. Okay, and again you can see that here I have substituted n equals to 2, because here also the term inside the caret has the 2. Okay, so this is how I have made the state at time t. Okay, now since we are asked to find the this inner product, okay, so let's do that. Okay, so further you can see that this can be written in this form also. Okay now what I am going to do, I am going to plug the value of psi, okay, and this psi from my previous equations that I have just calculated at time t, okay, and I have substituted the values, okay, here, okay, here and here, okay, as you can see that here. Okay, now further what I am going to do is that I am taking this dragger inside these terms, okay, and that can be written like this, okay. Okay, so on the writing that, the equation become like this. Okay, you can go through it. Okay, it's quite easy to understand. Okay, you don't have to worry too much. Okay, so it follows a simple rule. Okay, that is AB dragger equals to B dragger A dragger. Okay, so we use this rule while distributing this dragger inside. Also there is one another important rule while distributing it, and that I am going to write it here. Okay, I will write that here, that is A plus B dragger equals to A dragger plus B dragger. Okay, that rule I will use here. Okay, so finally, but I have not used it strictly, because that is not going to influence your results. Okay, right now, so the reason is that why I have not reversed the order is that here, because we are not dealing with the matrix, so it's they are only the simple scalar terms, so that's why the order does not matter as I have written here. Okay, so the order will not matter here in this case, because there is no matrix here. Okay, so now you can see that how I wrote this. Okay, you can go through it. Okay, and this is how I got this equation. Okay, okay. Now you have to know that what is tracker. If the there is a matrix, if there is a matrix, okay, if there's a matrix, for example, if A is a matrix, okay, and you apply the tracker over it, then first what is the meaning of this tracker? Okay, so that tracker means that first you have to transpose that matrix, okay, and then replace each element by its complex conjugate. Okay, so that means that is the meaning of the tracker. Because there is no matrix, we will only put the complex conjugate. Okay, okay. And what is the complex conjugate means? The complex conjugate means you have to replace I by minus I, okay, in the terms. Okay, okay. So as you can see that this is the real quantity, so now this the dragger won't affect it, also the dragger won't affect this also. Okay, and but now this, when you operate the dragger on the cat vector, it becomes the bra vector. So this is an important point for you to note down this thing. Okay, okay. Now you can also see that here is the complex number, so the dragger has to do the transpose as well as the complex conjugate, but here there's no matrix, so dragger will only do the complex conjugate inside the term. So that will do like that, and you will get this much term. Okay, okay. So now on putting these values back in this equation, okay, from here, okay, from here if I put the values back in this equation, okay, then I arrive at this equation. Okay, okay. And then what I'm going to do right now is that I am now going to multiply the factors inside. So first I will multiply this with this, and then I will multiply this with this, and then I will multiply this with this. Okay, so this is how I have multiplied here the factors, and you can go through it. Okay, now here what I'm going to do is that I'm now going to make the use of the orthonormal properties. Okay, so this is the orthonormal property of the wave function. If here m equals to n, then that gives me the 1. If m and if n is not equals to m, that gives me the 0. So if you look back at the previous equation, okay, here, so you can see that here are the terms. Okay, and these can easily be solved with the help of that orthonormal property. Okay, here also and here also. So if you look at this point, then this will simply give you 1, this will give you 0, this will give you 0, and this will give you 1. Okay, so this is how you can solve it further. Okay, now according to this, this will be 1, this will be 1, this will be 0, and this will be also 0. So on putting these values in the previous equation, okay, you can arrive at this equation, and then you will solve it, you will get this, and this sine square plus cos square theta is equal to 1, and this is your answer. So this is how you got your answer. So thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please share with your friends, like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much, friends. Thank you.